program. My name is Adrian Walsh, and I have been proud to be a Cobra now for 13 years. What a privilege it is to announce some special guests that is in attendance here today to commemorate this golden milestone. Would you all please join me in welcoming the first class of Jackson Heights High School, the class of 1970.
Steel door for the last time in 1964,
and reopened as a school in 1969. After obtaining the land and all structures on it for the amount of $1, the school district known as Jackson Heights was born. The surrounding towns of Circleville, Soldier, Netawaka, and Whiting were now able to send their 154 students to one school. Through the years, the school has seen many faces come and go, but the rich history has remained constant. Camera crews and reporters like the one from the Stars and Stripes that came this summer still visit the building today. The school's unique past has earned a permanent place in the spotlight for Jackson Heights. These words are by Sarah Schirmer in the 1999 yearbook with the theme, "That Was Then, This Is Now." And they spoke to me 20 years later as I prepared for today's 50-year celebration. It was then, in 1969, that the school's dedication program started with an invocation. And I'd like to start our program now the same way. It is my honor to introduce to you Tim Algren, class of 1989.
He grabbed me by the shoulder. Him and Coach Henry both used to do this little, they'd squeeze your shoulder really hard and see if it made you wince, and you had to just smile and act like it didn't hurt. And so he did one of those, and he said, Tim, he said, you need to remember something. He said, you are here at the greatest school in the greatest county in the greatest state in the greatest country in the world. And I've always remembered that, Jim. I really appreciate that. And, if I could say one thing to you, I would say that. Let's have a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, today we come before you as they came 50 years ago in the exact same type of services we're having right now. And as they came before you and they said, Lord, please bless the future of this school. And as they looked forward to all the things that they had planned for this district and all the ways they knew difficulties were going to need to be overcome, as merging all these towns together and all these people together that were former rivals, and melding them together as one group. Lord, today we come before you and we say thank you, because you have certainly accomplished a great and wonderful thing. Lord, I thank you today for all the past and present teachers that we've had here at the school. We've had some really great ones that have imparted great knowledge and have done encouraging things and have just been fantastic. Father, we thank you so much for that. We thank you, Lord, for all those that have sacrificed so much in the beginning and all along the course of this past 50 years to keep this school running, keep it operating. All the kids that have gone to school and all the members that have served on school boards and that have been part of the community and been to games and supported all of the activities that have gone on here. Father, I thank you for many generations of Cobras. I thank you that I can be a part of them. I thank you, Father, that my children had an opportunity to be a part of them. And Father, I look forward to many more generations being Cobras as well. Father, I thank you that so many lives, not only in this community, but literally all around the world, are successful because of the education that they've received here. Father, I thank you for all the lessons that have been learned academically, and in sports, and music, and all across the board. You've been so gracious to allow those things to happen, Lord. I ask you one more thing today. We ask, Father, as we look forward to the next 50 years, that those kids that are here in the middle of a school day, just glad to be out of class, but sitting here in this assembly, Father, I pray, Lord, for them. I pray, Father, you'll just continue to raise them up to be strong young men and women that are active parts of the community, that love this community and love their country. Father, we just thank you for that. And as we look into the next future, or into the next 50 years, ask, Lord, that you will just continue to pour out your blessing upon Jackson Heights, that many, many more will say that they are proud to be a Cobra. Father, we love you. Pray this in Jesus' name.
The last 50 years for me, I spent taught school after I got out of the Army in 75, and then I changed careers and I became a hospital administrator. I'm not sure if that was a good move, but I did that for 35 years, and then I retired in 2011. And I got bored, and so I started doing interim jobs to help hospitals through the time when they were getting new CEO. And now I do some consulting for the Kansas Hospital Association, and I really enjoy that. But thank you for inviting me back. I just can't tell you what this means.
Dreams and racing all the time.
who could speak to us today, many names came to mind. But one that was really at the top of my list was a good friend and colleague that I'm very proud to introduce to everyone. I know of nobody that has more Cobra spirit, more green and gold pride, and knows more about Cobra history as a student, coach, and staff member. So please welcome class of 1979 graduate, Mrs. Joe Hufford.
Was represented as state. This just made us more determined to work harder to not let that happen again. Our senior year found our boys team battling a tough volleyball team in the final game of the regular basketball season. After a hard-fought battle, Valley defeated us and claimed the league championship. A week later, we would be facing them again in the finals of South State. This time, Jackson Heights would come on top, earning a trip to state. The following week, on a Saturday night, in front of a packed house at the Municipal Auditorium in Topeka, now known as most to you, the Topeka Performing Arts Center, we would be crowned 2A state champions. The five starters and the sixth man would all be seniors from the class of 79. Looking around this gem of the banners hanging on the walls, one could say, our class played a part in the continuing winning tradition that Jackson Heights was and continues to be known for. When I think of traditions, riding the pep bus to the football and basketball games would definitely be one. This was the first opportunity as a freshman to interact with the upperclassmen. We weren't attached to a phone, nor did we have earphones in our ears listening to music. We were actually talking and laughing with each other the entire way. We sang songs, 100 bottles of beer on the wall, our favorite, did cheers and chants, and everything else that one would do on the bus ride to a game. We loved putting the windows down as we would travel through the different towns on the way to the game, shouting at the top of our lungs, C-C-C-O-B-R-R-R-E-S-C-O-B-R-E-S, Cobras, Cobras, Cobras. Pep club? Yes. That was actually a club one would join each year. We were all scared to death of Mr. Thomas. He made all of the freshman classes sit in alphabetical order. I believe he did this so he could learn our names easier. We all wondered why his ties matched his slacks, and would soon learn that his wife actually made them. Once basketball started, and we, the basketball girls, got to know him better, we would joke with him in class. This drove the boys crazy, as they just knew we were going to cause him to give one of his famous pop quizzes. To this day, I can still see him standing at the overhead projector, using the small piece of sponge to clean the overhead, ready to show another example of a math goddess. Other memories of my high school days would include the payphone in the hall by the office door, the weight room being on the stage, the semicircle sinks in the restroom, running up and down the tunnel and hopping up the stairs as part of our basketball conditioning, learning to type on a manual typewriter and taking shorthand, never knowing what contraption Mr. White might bring to English class to use as part of a lesson, passing through the tunnel to get from one part of the downstairs to the other, wearing your boyfriend's class ring so everyone knew you were going steady, being scared to death of getting called to the office by Mr. Clark or Mr. Sheldon. Were you going to get the paddle for something you shouldn't have done? I don't remember there being in-school or out-of-school suspensions. The paddle usually got the message across. And a personal memory of mine, running to Fulton to get donuts every Friday for Coach Henry as I was in classroom pain. Before I knew it, May 1979 would be here, graduation time. 4 years ago, we entered the doors as graduates. Now we were leaving as a class that had left our mark on the traditions of Jackson Heights. So many memories. They all played a part in the traditions. So many teachers. They were all a part of the successes of the students at JH. Fast forward to the fall of 1983. Thanks to Mr. Clark and Mr. Moser, I was returning to my stomping grounds in a new role as an elementary teacher. Now it was my turn to be a part of the lives of the students of JH. Could I make a difference like those who have made a difference in my life? Wow, what big shoes to fill. With the guidance of many colleagues, I embarked on a career as a third grade teacher. 33 years later, would remember. Maybe it was the Ag Day that I organized for a few years that the entire grade school would get to participate in. Or the assigning of a country for the Winter Olympics that each class followed their medal count. Mrs. Watkins and myself started team teaching social studies and science by combining our third and fourth grade classes. Thus, our students were referred to as the group. Would it be Grandparents' Day celebration that I started when our son Britton was in third grade? Or the March Madness bracket students used to learn about each team in the NCAA basketball tournament, the college they were representing, or the state they were from? I loved razzing the K-State fans, wondering if the Wildcats would even make the tournament, let alone the Final Four that KU always had a chance of doing. There were the trading cards we made and traded that represented the Iditarod, that represented the musher each student was assigned to follow in the Iditarod dog sled race, or the Kentucky Derby horse they participated in. These are a few that come to mind. When I retired, my teaching partner, Christy Altenberg, had gathered memories from former and present students that I had had. Here would be the true testimony. Did I make a difference in the lives of the students I had taught? While preparing for what I was going to share today, I went back and reread all the memories. I would like to share a few of these with you. From Mary Bill Tildebrand, a student I had in my first class, she stated, "I remember being around the world champ while learning my multiplication and division facts." From Leah Tanking Tome, the class of 2004, "I found my love of geography from learning the states and capitals. Because of that, I love to travel and visit all the state capitals." And lastly, from Jason Mosley, a current JH sophomore, "I would love to travel back in time and be in your class again." Boy, I treasure these memories. One can honestly say that teachers make a difference in the lives of those they teach. The administration also gave me the opportunity to coach. I was able to coach at the state basketball tournament with Mr. Thomas. Yes, he was that math teacher I had as a freshman, whom we were all scared of. One person I had the utmost respect for. I coached many years with Mr. Penton as a junior high girls basketball coach. And when they couldn't find someone, I became the first female junior high boys basketball coach. I was given the chance to coach a sport that I had never played, volleyball. Thankful for Mr. Bonch and having patience with me, I was learning the sport alongside the players. These volleyball girls I helped coach made history by being the first team to participate at the state volleyball tournament, taking fourth place. While reading my birthday wishes on social media this week, former players stated, "Happy birthday, coach." That word coach is still music to my ears. People ask me if I miss teaching. My answer, I miss the students and I miss my colleagues. Would you change your career path? Definitely not. I can't think of a more rewarding career than one as a teacher and coach. In closing, I can't think of any place I would have wanted to have spent the majority of my life. I honestly can say I came full circle. Thanks to the district who educated me for 15 years and then took a chance on me when they hired me as a teacher. Jackson High told that there is a special place in my heart, and I know it always will. My husband tells me my blood runs green and gold, and I truly believe that. Thanks for allowing me to share with you today. I'm proud to call myself a JH Cobra. Thank you.
Thank you.
School is lucky to have two fabulous fourth grade teachers in Ms. McAlpine and Mrs. Latham. This year, they decided to start the year challenging both classes with a special research project in honor of the 50th anniversary of Jackson Heights High School. Through the project, students saw never-before-seen photos of family members in yearbooks, learned about Cobra history, and created decade boards to share with all of you today. So sit back, relax, and enjoy some great green and gold memories as they are told by our very own Jackson Heights Elementary School fourth graders.
Football champs won against Troy.
In 1979, boys basketball won 2A state championship.
Thank you. day celebration, we thought it would be fun to take a stroll down memory lane for past and present Cobras. First up are our two favorite Jackson Heights High School science teachers with the Cobra. Mr. Gary Keene is carrying the full body original Cobra, and Mr. Travis Henry is carrying the current Cobra that we believe started in 2003. My, the Cobra has changed from then till now. The Cobra spirit remains the same. Jim Schumann, class of 1970, and the first homecoming team is modeling his letter jacket, and Cooper Williams, class of 2020, is here to show his letter jacket 50 years later. This trio of football studs is giving us a glance at Cobra football gear. Riley Watkins is supporting gear from 1997. Jude Williams is carrying Charlie Walji's football helmet from 1972, and Carson Williams is giving us a sneak peek at the uniforms you will see tonight. Now we have a special mother-daughter pair displaying cheerleading fashion from 1994 and 2019. Thank you, Dennis and Mallory Caldwell. What about cross country? Check out Shelby Phillips, who is ready to run in a 2019 uniform, while her current teammate, Jill Buck, is in a 1990s uniform. Basketball. Kylie Bowles, 1990s. Abby Graves, 1980s. Kylie Gold and Abby Gray, class of 2020 and 2019 state basketball qualifiers, are modeling fast warm-ups. Abby is showing the 1980s and Kylie is wearing the 1990s.
All right. What does it mean to be a Cobra? Being a Cobra and being part of the Green and Gold family is a true honor. Jackson Heights High School is a remarkable place because of the people and the traditions. As we celebrate 50 years of excellence, I thought it was important to ponder the question, what does it mean to be a Cobra? And I asked four special individuals to help us answer that question. Mr. Jim Childs was a freshman when JHHS opened its doors in the fall of 1969. 50 years later, he has come back home as a teacher and assists our students in creating amazing woods projects.
Hi, everybody. I remember you guys. 1970 graduates. You know, times were different back then. And I just want to tell you, I forgive you. In 1969, I was a skinny freshman at Jackson Heights High School. 50 years later, I'm still here. Mr. Thomas, I don't know if you're here, but he always told me that I was going to regret that algebra grade. He wasn't lying. Going to Jackson Heights High School has been six of the best years of my life. Anyway, in the beginning, it was not all peaches and cream. There was, let's just say, an adjustment period. Four little schools with tremendous pride and tradition and great rivalry against each other were thrown together to make one. It was not easy. Can you imagine KU, K-State, Missouri, and Texas all coming together and making one football team, or one basketball team, or one university? At first, one might ask, who just scored that touchdown? And you might hear in the stands, oh, that was Charlie Wolgie. He's a soldier boy. Or that was Keith Wilson. He's a Netawaka boy. As time elapsed, the same question might be asked again, and the answer quickly became, oh, that was so-and-so. He's a Cobra. We were coming together. Now I would say most fans don't know, or they don't care where each student comes from. They just know the Cobras. Over the years, I've been asked, what makes Jackson Heights so great? And after giving a great thought, you might say it's the facilities, because they have been tremendously upgraded from when I taught here before. Or no, it's the fact we're a rural school with rural values, where kids truly care about each other. Or maybe it's the tradition. However, the best answer to me to that question is you, and you, and you, and you. It's the people. That's what makes Jackson Heights, Jackson Heights. When I was a football coach, right before we took the field, I would always ask my team, where are you from? And they would say, Jackson Heights. So I would like all of you to stand up. And I'm going to ask the same question. Where are you from? We have a football game tonight. Good luck. Good luck, Cobras, for a great school year. Wave the banner high, because you are among greatness. And let's kick some tail tonight. Class of 73!
Track. You know, we decade of the fashion industry finally realized that the girls were going to wear Levi's. It didn't matter whether they were made for the guys or not, and so that was our jean fashion from all of that. And also, about the time of my graduation, the fashion of bell-bottoms came out. And not only bell-bottoms, but they were the big bells. And some of our pictures from going to skate, we would take pictures, and it was amazing that some people had the big bells, and they went across two people in front of them. That is one fashion statement I'm not sure will come back, so, which is maybe not a bad thing. You know, memories, you know, you don't really think about, you know, who has maybe formed you all the years that you were in Jackson Heights. But it seemed like as I was thinking back last night, I was thinking of different things that happened. And for some reason, it seemed like Mr. Thomas was always in those. And one of the things is you look at now, they're so worried about nutrition and, you know, we had pop machines. I'm not sure about candy. One of the things that happened in my algebra class, of course I don't remember anything about math, but I do remember this. He also got a science experimental one because we had a couple girls that decided they were going to eat M&Ms during class. And he told them, you better eat them now, get them gone, because it's not going to be a distraction in class. Well, they kind of played with them and held them. So he decided that we were going to find out, does M&Ms actually melt in your mouth, not in your hand? We found out they do melt in a person's hand. So anyway, then, you know, I kind of went with some of the things of, you know, coming from the heart and, you know, my family, what their ties were, you know, having my grandparents sit at they seemed to have reserve seats on old wooden bleachers out there on the half court line. You know, now we have Phyllis Shoup and Kenny Weichert and my mom sometimes they fight for that half court line. I just, you know, you just look back over the years and you just kind of are amazed at, you know, what all has happened and how old I am actually getting. You know, I'm trying to, you know, stay looking young, and of course everybody keeps bringing up the 1976 Grand State. And, you know, when people put a year to you, I don't know, there's just no hiding it anymore. It doesn't seem like. We have gotten no grief over the years, been inducted into, you know, the Basketball Hall of Fame. Coach Thomas has gotten Coach of the Year. There's been many, many things that has happened there. But I also want to talk about a little bit of behind-the-scenes things that happened. Not during Mr. Thomas's years, but the first year that I was basketball, we got on the bus every night and we went to Circleville to practice. And we only had one senior, which was Elaine Reese, and one junior that was Pam Reese. So all the rest of us was a lot younger than that. And I feel like that Elaine gave a very good role model to the work ethics that happened during that time. I do want to talk about Mr. Thomas and his promise in that 1975-76 year that he promised us that we would not have to do sprints any longer as long as we kept winning. Well, I guess sloppy wins don't work for him, because not only did so he made us feel it for a few days that, you know, you either play your game or you're going to be sore the next day. So we did that. One of the things that people probably don't realize that the first time that when I was playing basketball, the boys and the girls did not play on the same night. So our family and friends, I don't know how they managed, because Monday and Thursday nights, we traveled, the boys on Tuesdays and Friday nights. And, you know, that is probably something that truly brought our fans together too, was we spent the whole week, nights and weekends, together with everybody else in our district. And another thing that I think is kind of ironic, after the fashion show, we had homemade basketball uniforms. Nancy Van Dong was our coach, and I'm not sure who her friend was, sister. Anyway, our uniforms were homemade. So a lot of things have changed over the years, and probably all for the better, I would say. So I just kind of wanted to come back that we are definitely proud of the 1976 Grand State Championship. You know, when I was in school, I actually got to go to state 3 times. So, and then I can also remember Coach Thomas, when we won the state as a senior, he says, "Guess what, girls? We're coming back next week." And so that was the Grand State. Of course, it was our final hurrah, but it was definitely a wonderful ride. And as far as the Cobra family, I don't think that there could be any prouder people supporting the school than we have here at Jackson Heights. I feel like the, you know, the caravans that went out, we had pep rallies here. They watched us leave. They followed us all the way to Hayes. At the hotel rooms, they did, you know, pep rallies out there. We were, you know, actually treated like royalty. Sometimes you don't appreciate that until you, you know, get older. But I think Jo was right in her saying that, you know, there wasn't anybody left probably in Jackson County. And a lot of those people milked. They came, they would drive out, and then they came back. And so I just want to personally say thank you for all your support over all the years.
Was a sophomore when Jackson Heights High School opened its doors in 1969 and has touched the lives of many students and staff members working in both school buildings. Please welcome her.
Then I thought, on a 50-year mighty Cobra, I can do this. I was in the first sophomore class at Jackson Heights High School. Before school started in the fall of 69, some of the diehard soldier chargers was a little uneasy about this new adventure, but we were resilient. It didn't take us long to bounce back from the thought of losing our hometown school. We met new classmates, we became a team in sports and as a school. By the end of the first school year, we had already made lifelong friends in this newly born Coberland. We were a united front. Now, 50 years later, the mighty Cobras are still a united front. Just look around you. The proof of resilience and unity is through our friendships, our children, and our grandchildren. The proof is on these gym walls. We continue to be the mighty, mighty Cobras.
Without Mr. Charlie Woolgee, who has a special place in the Cobra history books as the first Jackson Heights High School track champion, and he is a school record holder. He was also a USD 335 board member for 8 years. Please welcome him.
Adrian called me yesterday and asked me if I'd like to speak a little bit about what it's like to be a Cobra. I thank her for that, and I thank her for giving me 24 hours to prepare. I have lots of fond memories of Jackson Heights. Some of you folks in the front row aren't going to be in this part, but I remember walking in the front door as a 150-pound, thick-skinned sophomore. And I remember my first thought as I walked through the door is, how am I going to remember all my classmates? I know the sound of an acronym, but didn't worry about that. Jim? That was one of my worries. It didn't take long. I found my classrooms. Unfortunately, God did not give me the talent or the drive to be up for valedictorian honors. So most of my memories are going to be about sports. I remember that first year coming in, we didn't have a football field. We didn't have a track. We played our home football games in Netawaka, where the ball diamond is now. Sometimes the lights would stay on for the whole game, sometimes they didn't. We did have a gym, we had this gym, but we had a two or three more boards down on the end. I think Tony remembers that. A lot of them got under the floor, and of course we had to be careful when we started practicing, but they both fit by the time the season started. I remember, as I said, most of my memories will be sports related. I remember the very first year, Mr. Mullins talked about it. We had kind of 72 records overall. We pulled four schools together. They were the rivals. We knew some of them knew each other, some of us didn't. Basketball, we had a good year that year. I didn't play that other record. Fortunately, in my junior year, I was a small part of a very talented basketball team that finished fourth in the state. I think to this day probably had the talent to win the tournament. Become kind of just a 6'8 kid from a Kraken, Brian Shelton, some of you remember, played basketball in Notre Dame. I moved into my senior year. I was lucky enough to play on a very talented football team that finished second in the state that year. I remember a cold, rainy Saturday, close to 300 fans followed us, followed the bus to Sterling, Kansas, to be playing Little River. We got off that bus, we thought we had a shot really that game. They handed our tails to us, but we were there. We got a second place trophy, and we got a second place medal. I was also fortunate enough to have some success as a track, as a sprinter, and a long jumper. I remember my favorite meet every year is stage at Hitch Park. That was the only time in my high school career I got to run on the other track. Our track field is dirt. If it was raining, it was mud. Our long jump camp is too short. But we have a couple track meets. As I said, I was lucky to have a little bit of God-given speed and just enough athletic ability to make the teams. I have some very, very talented athletes. Some of them are here. As Adrian mentioned, I love to mention that she did. She did play the state championship in long jump. Jump was 22-11 and a quarter. That was a record for 20 years. It's something I'll be proud of the rest of my life. There are many people at Jackson Heights that have influenced my life as a student and as an adult. Community mentioned coaches, teachers, supporters. This school has had great support from day one and until today. I see some of the folks in the audience right now that came to ball games when I played. I think they still come from it. As I said, approximately 300 of them followed us to Sterling to watch us. They were a tail failure to us in March tonight. He was on the basketball team that we took Portland State that year. And as I said, I think they had the talent to win. It didn't work out. I said, there are many people in for my life. A lot of people to thank. I can't mention them all. I would like to mention one person that meant a lot to me as a student. As an adult, I am privileged to spend 3 years in school as a student under his direction, and almost 8 years on the Board of Education. He was a principal, superintendent, and he even coached track 1 year. That's Mr. Robert Clark. He was tough, but he was fair. I have to tell the story about Mr. Carr. It was our sophomore year. Mr. Mullins, who was our football coach, left shortly after football to be in the service. Thank you for your service, sir. So our basketball coach at that time was supposed to coach track. Mr. Clark happened to walk in the gymnasium one day during basketball practice, and our basketball coach was going up in the bleachers. So he was informed he would not be coaching basketball the following year, so he decided he wasn't going to coach track. I didn't know if he was going to have a track team or not. We had probably six kids on track, maybe. I was walking in the hall one day, Mr. Clark stepped out and said, "Charlie, I need to talk to you." So we go into his office, he put his head down, and he said, "You know, Charlie, we are going to have a track team. And I, Mr. Thomas, are going to coach the track team." He said, "I recruited Mr. Thomas." I figured probably Mr. Thomas held his hand up one or two, but he did recruit him. He said, his words to me were, "We'll have a track team. I don't know a lot about track." He said, "We'll get you to the track meets. And then you do your part. You run fast and you jump far." And you know, it worked. It worked out. But open my memories of Jackson Heights, probably the thing that really encourages me about the place is the families. Like I said, I see faces in the audience that came to my ball game and probably still come to ball games. So, and I want to thank Adrian and whoever helped put this on. It was awesome. I wouldn't miss it. The football helmet is not for sale. There's folks that accuse me of walking out the door with that. It's not true. My real mother bought me that for graduation. That was my senior helmet. It's a brand new helmet that year. Thank you all very much.
Good afternoon, Cobras.
My name is Derek Stewart. Circleville, Kansas. I am a proud 1990 graduate of Jackson Heights, and I'm truly humbled to be the 712 principal at this great institution. I am truly honored to be standing up here in front of you this afternoon for this special occasion to celebrate our 50 years. Jackson Heights is a special place. One would ask what makes this a special place, and I think that's an easy answer. And Mr. Jim Child said it best, it is the people. It is the people that walk the hallways, it is the people in the classrooms, it is the people that make this place the greatest ever. And as Mr. Childs, I think Tim Algren, him and I had a similar commonality. I also was his teacher aide. He had all the best students, didn't he, Jim? And I did appreciate the times when he allowed me to work on projects and also watch a little football film on the side while he was teaching the students. But it is the people that previously walked the hallways and those who currently do. As we look back, we know that it started with the support of our parents who helped us get us up in the mornings and get us around the next school day. To the bus drivers who drove us safely to and from school. To the custodians, the cooks who fed us well and continue to feed us well. The secretaries, our teachers, our coaches, our administrators, our board members, and all the students who have been a part of the Jackson Heights family. We have spent a lot of time sharing memories of all the extracurricular activities and success that we've had here, and as is noted in our gym walls, for the past 50 years. At this time, I do want to take, as a building administrator, stress the time and success that we've had in the classroom. The education that has been offered for the past 50 years was and is priceless. If we as students chose to take advantage of what was successful, Jackson Heights taught us to do our best when we put on that jersey and to do our best when we were in the classroom. I now challenge those students in attendance who will be a part of the next 50 years, do your best, become productive citizens, and be thankful to be a Cobra. Also, be thankful for the freedoms we have to attend this great school. I would like to take this opportunity to thank those who served in the military that helped provide those freedoms that we have today. If you served or currently are serving, would you please rise at this time? Thank you for your service. I also would like to take this moment to have a moment of silence for those Cobras that we have lost. Thank you. To the alumni of Jackson Heights, and for all those in attendance, I would like to thank you for attending this special event. I would like to also reach out and thank our superintendent of schools, Mrs. Adrian Waltz, for her leadership in organizing this event. I do want to remind that this evening, everyone is invited. Johnsonville will be here to have a tailgate for all the Cobras starting at 5:30 this evening in the Commons area. Cake and punch will also be served. But before we conclude this ceremony, the next item on the program requires some audience participation. I know Mr. Jim Childs had a good warm up there, so now we're gonna invite our current cheerleaders at the high school level. They can come up to the stage, please. And it is our standing tradition, as Mrs. Jill Pufford had mentioned earlier in her speech, that we do the Cobra cheer, and that is the CCCOB. And obviously, we all know that well, as I have heard it since the 80s. Going through school. So I will start with the students who graduated in the 70s. If you could stand at this time, those students who graduated in the 70s, if you would stand and join the cheerleaders in singing CCCOB. Ladies, on their marks, let's go. Graduate 1980s, stand up, please. In the 80s. Here we are, this group might be loud here. In the 80s, ladies, cheerleaders, and 80s graduates.
And the 1990s. Where's my 90 folks back here? Yes, here we go. Loud and proud, 90s.
Cobras.
All right, this should be a bigger crowd. 2000 to 2019. Let's go, there we are. There's our group. All right, Cobras. Go ahead, Cobras. Okay, now we want the current K through 12 students and staff to stand up. The current K through 12 students and staff, faculty.